Update. Am I the asshole for trying to send my deaf daughter to a school that won't hire an interpreter? Thank you all for your advice on my last post. I wasn't aware of all the laws about this kind of thing. For those of you who didn't read the op, basically my 6-year-old daughter is deaf and communicates using ASL. There is a public school near us, but it's very bad and the whole district has a rating of 1.5, 5 stars. All of our other children go to a private school near us. But the private school said they wouldn't pay for an interpreter because there is a deaf school in our county, but the deaf school only teaches speech and no sign language, so we decided not to send her there. We also wanted her to go to the private school because there was a language option for ASL so she may be able to communicate with other classmates. But my brother said that we shouldn't push trying to get her in. If the school doesn't want her, we should just give up. Most people said to hire a lawyer. My husband decided to contact his brother, who is a disability lawyer. Although he specializes in wheelchair accessibility, he was willing to take our case. We discussed the situation over the phone with him, and then he reached out to the private school. He emailed back and forth with the school. We're not sure what was said exactly, but by the end of it, not only did the school agree to pay for the interpreter, but they also provided a free scholarship and let us request which teacher she had, which they didn't let us do for any of our other kids. There is a kindergarten teacher who knows some ASL, so we chose to be in her class. I'm not sure exactly why they did this, but I think it's probably because denying entry to a kindergartner just because she's deaf would not look so good if other people found out. But I'm not complaining. She started 2 weeks ago and she loves it. They are doing hybrid. She is able to make friends and talk to other kids, though in kinda broken sign language. Her interpreter is very nice and will update us on how she did every day, unlike the interpreter she had when she was in public school. Her teacher also tried to sign when she's speaking as much as possible, and so do some of the kids. Overall, I'm so happy this happened, and I wouldn't have known there was anything I could do about it until I asked on here, so thank all of you who replied to the op and told me they do have to provide an interpreter for her. Edit. My pronouns are she, her. I'm not sure why everyone's referring to me as a male, but just wanted to let you all know. Edit 2. To everyone concerned as to why my brother-in-law is a disability lawyer, but I came to Reddit first. We barely talk to Bill. He's my husband's half-brother and there is a 16-year age gap, so they aren't close. And at the time when I first posted, I didn't think I could do anything legally. I talked about why in the comments, so I didn't even think of talking to my Bill. I was just concerned if I was being too pushy, which is why I came to this sub rather than legal advice. Hope that clears some things up.
Good job on following through and working for your daughter. I'm not sure where you are, but rest assured that school is going to get their scholarship money back through government grants and tax breaks. It makes me happy to know private schools are being expected to meet the same basic standards as public schools, especially when so much money is being funneled away from the public for the private schools, at least in the USA.
Op. I love reading about a child doing well. I imagine she'll have a class full of kids who learn ASL, which is great for all of them. She may have plenty of fights in her life to get what she needs, and you are showing her that she is worth the fight.
Not the asshole. You're not an asshole for strong-arming this school into the current century. The only reason that children with disabilities have any accommodations afforded to them in school is because of parents like you. Parents of special needs children have to push for their kids, because no one else will. You did the right thing. Not only for your kid, but for future kids who will want to attend that school and need an interpreter.
Definitely not the asshole. However, kind of surprised that you didn't reach out to your in-law, who's a disability lawyer, sooner. Seems like that should have been the first line of defense.
A bit off topic, but if I had a deaf classmate in my nursery who used the sign language, I'd have literally gone crazy. Being able to communicate using your hands and special signs as a young child. Man, I would have bugged your daughter so much all the time. Looks like she will probably teach some ASL to the other children.
Lol, they changed their position because what they were doing was illegal and they realized that they were opening themselves up to a massive lawsuit.
Fantastic job. You will always be your child's strongest advocate. If you haven't already, start reading up on AITA, FAPE, IEPs, 504 plans. There are a lot of good websites to help guide you. Rights Law has always been a favorite of mine. My sister has a mild physical disability, but it's become more mild as she's grown up. A lot of teachers assumed that because she had a physical disability, she had a mental one too. They wanted her in lower sets and doing the low-level exams. My mom had to be the pushy parent to ensure my sister was treated fairly and given the best shot in life. She needed this and is living the life she wants to. She's got a great career that she loves, a wonderful husband, and her disability is so much more under control than we ever could have hoped. You'd barely know. Your daughter deserves the opportunities that you're giving her. Your brother is well-meaning but doesn't understand what it is like to have a disabled child. You have to push to get them equal rights.
Not exactly related, but when I saw the firefighter signing the Pledge of Allegiance while speaking it at the inauguration, I teared up a little. That being said, of course, you're not the asshole, and I'm glad everything worked out.
This is amazing and great, but this is also another reason I hate private schools. They are only about getting money, and usually skirt regulations. My short experience with a private school was all about making sure to fundraisers, even though I pay for my child to go, and being told any special learning support would be done at the public school, then why am I paying you? Hopefully you are not experiencing these problems. I am happy your child is doing wonderful.
What a lovely outcome. It's so nice to start my work week with a good news story. Thanks for the update.
Ah, the old Reddit assumption all people are male. Thanks for the update. Glad to hear it all worked out.
I am appalled that there are still deaf schools that don't allow sign. I thought that went out in the 1950s.
Congratulations. But this is perplexing. My husband decided to contact his brother who is a disability lawyer. And your first thought instead of the disability lawyer in the family was to ask Reddit? I mean, yeah, his subspecialty is ramp accessibility, but still.
Trying to wrap my head around op that has an immediate family member who literally practices disability law and they posted on Reddit instead of mentioning it to him.
This is the kind of update that makes me wish I didn't just give out my last award. I am so happy for OP's kid.
This is why laws about disability and discrimination exist. Your lawyer kindly explained the disability laws or your local equivalent. Sorry, no deafs is a huge violation. There's a long sad history of dead people being excluded from education and labeled stupid, when they were simply denied access. I would be wary of the school management. Their initial decision was offensive, cruel and short-sighted. Your daughter will actually be a massive benefit to the school. She and her friends will hopefully all learn ASL together, and at a great age to be learning this stuff. That's important exposure for all. Good job.
What a great outcome. I was teaching a young boy in my public school class who was severely hard of hearing and also from a Spanish-speaking family. His family refused to allow him to learn sign language since they didn't know it and we wouldn't teach in it Spanish. I fought so hard for him but against his own parents, not the school. Sheesh.
Color me shocked. Private schools don't have to pay for accommodations like public ones do. They have to offer the option, and then the parents can foot the bill. Sounds like you really lucked out.
This made my day. Love a happy ending. You are never the asshole for advocating for your child's right to be treated fairly. I think the entitled parents badge only applies when you expect your child to be treated over and above everyone else for no good reason.
Lovely. Depending on the law where you are, rejecting a child for reasons that count as discrimination is a huge lawsuit waiting to happen. Like, yeah, you can reject children because they won't be a good fit for our school, but once you documented you're rejecting a child because they're disabled, of a certain race, follow a certain religion, whatever else your law considers discrimination, you effed up big time.
People are referring to you as a male because they assume everyone on Reddit is a man. It's not personal. I absolutely loved reading the ending to this, and I'm so glad your daughter is loving school. Thanks for posting the update. That's so awesome. Advocating for your daughter is so important and will continue to be important. I think I commented on the op, but again, if you have any questions or need support, please don't hesitate to contact me. I am a speech-language pathologist at a school for the deaf that uses exclusively ASL. I have a lot of parent-friendly resources I can share. Good luck to you and your daughter.
Please make sure the interpreter is certified. Some interpreters is not certified can interpret in school. That's sometime cause some confusion.
Such a wonderful outcome. Yeah, it's definitely against the law to discriminate against a disabled child. If you went to the media, they would absolutely annihilate the school, and they couldn't even sue you for defamation or libel. I'm sure your brother-in-law pointed those things out, and that convinced them to change their attitude quick smart. Congratulations. Good on you for standing up for your child and pushing back against discrimination and injustice. I hope she's very happy at school, and that her classmates enjoy learning ASL over the next few years. Smile.
What a great update. They probably rolled out the red carpet so there would be no more trouble after your brother-in-law reminded them of AITA laws.
Brother-in-law laid down AITA Act laws and told them to straight up or be sued, I bet.
FYI, even though she attends a private school, she may be entitled to free services from the public school system. You can get her set up with an individualized education plan with a private school support plan. You can request psychological, educational, speech language, audiological, and whatever other evaluations needed. Be sure to make requests in writing. Email is good because it also documents when requests were made. Best of luck.
Oh, that's so good. Good for you. You are a great mom. Tell your brother to find his backbone. His argument is bullshit. This was a fight worth having and your daughter will be better for it. Think about it from the kid's perspective. She is now able to make friends and they are also happy to learn to communicate with her. She just as easily could have grown up feeling embarrassed about this, but at least now she is starting out on a good path.
You're not the asshole, you're a desperately needed advocate for your child. This update makes my heart so happy. That is a great update. Glad it worked out for you. I always was intrigued about learning ASL. Maybe it's a way for me to help out those organizations that need volunteers to help.
In all of the often sad, upsetting posts on this subreddit, reading updates such as yours are just the best. I'm glad your brother-in-law was able to help, and that your daughter is having a good time at school. This makes me very happy.
I gotta say, this really hit hard. I have a grin from ear to ear. I'm so glad to see that little girl has a whole network of love and support. It really set her up for a much better education and overall life experience. Heart.
This is awesome. I'm significant other glad she is able to get the schooling she deserves.
I am deaf and just want to thank you for fighting for your daughter. She is lucky to have parents that will advocate for her so fiercely, and by doing so you are teaching her to do the same for herself when she is older. Heart. This is wonderful. I am so happy for your family that you followed through and had such a great outcome.
Fantastic job advocating for your daughter. I hope this continues to be a great fit for her. Your relative probably put the fear of God into them with their unlawful conduct to you prior to his getting involved. So I imagine them bending over backwards as to prevent the ramifications of their actions through the legal system of the court of public opinion. I'm very glad that your daughter was able to get an interpreter. You are clearly a great parent, judging by your drive to make sure she is able to communicate with more than just her interpreter, and to get a good education to boot. Thumbs up. That private school realized they were breaking the AITA. That's why they're bending over backwards now. Glad this worked out for you. Her being at that school benefits them way more than her, and hopefully they'll realize that.
Amazing advocacy. I do hate it that the moment you get a lawyer, schools cave. Like, why not try and work things out before you are afraid of getting sued or looking bad?
This update made my day. Yes. Congrats on making a new wonderful path for your deaf daughter. I had to fight for an interpreter from grade 7th to 11th grade, because the nearest school didn't want to provide for a deaf student. It was a horrible experience, and me being 12 to 16 had have to fight for interpreter while no adult lifted a finger to help me. I lost hope. Please don't ever let that happen to your daughter like what happened to me.
Wow. This is beautiful.
I really don't understand why the school who offers ASL as a second language option for their kids won't allow for a deaf child and an interpreter. That makes no sense. You think it'd be an even greater opportunity for them to show inclusivity and how their classes are useful at such a young age. Wow, this just made me cry. I don't know why. I am not deaf, nor is anybody in my family or close circle. I think maybe because when I was a kid, I had, and still have, an invisible disability, ADHD. I didn't get the accommodations I needed to help me succeed, so growing up and going to school was a lot harder than it needed to be. So hearing about your daughter getting what she needs and more just warms my heart. Big hugs to you all, especially your sweet daughter.
What a wonderful outcome. Thanks so much for updating this post.